Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac, Rebirth. We have to get a mom's heart, I should say, on Judas and Samson. Well, I would guess that Samson kill is probably not going to happen anytime soon, so let's go with our Judas option here. I thought for sure, like, do I not have Basement Boy? I suppose I'll check that in between these episodes, but I thought I had Basement or Spelunker Boy. And if I had Basement or Spelunker Boy, that would mean that I fulfilled the requirements to get Samson, which is just don't take damage for two floors. Just don't take damage for two floors. Oh, it's gonna be a good run. We got Mom's Eyeshadow, Charm Tears. Not the most OP item in the game by any stretch of the imagination, but a pretty darn good one. Allows you to turn enemies to your own side, which, as you saw right there, can have nice consequences when those enemies do a little bit of shooting of their own. Now, no Judas run is easy. Alright, well, this is gonna be interesting. Charm the gurglings. Charm the gurglings. Aw, shit. I'm telling you guys, gurglings, way more difficult. Way more difficult than Dingle. It's because of the knockback. Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here. Oh, and the creep. The creeps is... also make it pretty bad. Thank you for being charmed. Thank you for smoking. Please get out of my house and never return. One more hit. Two more hits. Oh, we did it. Okay, so we get evil up. Plus some bombs. From the matchbook. Three bombs. Whew, I had to take it. Because the black heart might actually keep us alive. Now, with evil up, I expect... I don't really know what unlocks, or what the stat is that I believe my hypothesis is affects deals with the devil. The deal with the devil chances, I should say. If it's either evil or sin. Either way, I have to take it, but I would love, you know, Cain's the kind of character, sorry, Judas is the kind of character where you can totally have a deal with the angel run, and it makes sense because those items don't cost HP. But we pretty much have to take whatever we can to give ourselves the best chance possible of winning as well, unless we get HP, which is not looking so great right now. This floor is pretty much over. I wouldn't even be surprised if we didn't have enemies in our last room. No money there. But we were surprisingly survivable as a result of the pickups that we got. I'll shoot it. You never know. Sometimes you can just get like a lucky nickel out of these, and that can turn your run around in some cases. But for now, I'm excited with where we're at. All right. Decent first floor. I've got to say, I'm thrilled. Gurglings didn't kill me. It looked for a minute there like they probably would. I still can't believe that there's people who say Dingle's harder. Dingle's got tells, man. I'm not trying to start a big argument or anything like that, obviously. Dingle's got tells, and there's those poops in the corner that you just hide behind when they do their bullshit, like, charge attack. It's no problem, dog. Well, this is unfortunate so far. Can't access any of this, wonderful bounty that I would like to. Let's charm some of these diglets. I guess after we charm them, we should probably stop shooting them, huh? Because they can actually work with us. The charm doesn't last forever, but who wants to live forever anyway? Oh, yeah, that was terrible damage on my part. Instead of dodging, I directed all my mental energy to making that noise that you just heard. Ooh! In the future, might want to direct that energy you know, to my hands, maybe, or my, you know, other parts of my body, just so that I can actually execute that dodge appropriately. So, I will absolutely be interested in going to the curse room, but not yet. I will open that chest, though. Seriously, work with me here. Yeah, okay, we got a free bomb. We'll go to the curse room a little bit later once we know our HP situation is gonna be fine. Oh, snap! Okay, so we will go down this. Sometimes this just happens randomly. I know what's down there, I think. I can't say with any authority yet, but usually you'll get a little something-something for going down there. Sometimes I think it might actually allow you to skip floors like the shovel, but I'm guessing that that's not what it is in this case. And for those of you who have already seen that, you know what's up. This will be like the third or maybe even the fourth time I've seen it, but maybe the first time on camera. It's kind of a cool secret. I don't know what causes it. I'm pretty sure it's just random spots on the floor that give you the option sometimes. Oh, we have a key now, so we can actually, well, probably go to our shop. I still don't like this room, but just because I don't like it, that doesn't mean shit, basically. Still gotta do it. You know, I don't like paying my bills either, but you still gotta do that. Well, yeah, I guess you don't have to, but you really, really should. not just for the whole, you know, be a good person angle, but also, you know, in case you ever want to buy a house or something, or, you know, get an apartment, or, you know, a car, or, you know, a cell phone. Anyway, let's ignore that for now. Monstro, let's do this shit. Monstro, it seems like, is, like, guaranteed second floor boss, always. I'm being facetious, he's not guaranteed to be a second floor boss, but he does show up an awful lot, you've got to admit. Now, if I could just charm the pants off of you, mister, I would be really happy about that. There we go. After he gets charmed, like, I mean, he still jumps at us, but, you know, it's like a little bit more of a charming jump. It's like a, hey, come over here. Blood clot. Damage plus range up. I'm happy with it. Missing page 2 is like evil up. Oh, it's Dark Bum. Say it with me now. Celebrate good times. Come on. Dark Bum is widely considered perhaps the most overpowered item in the game. Makes it a very good choice for my Judas run where I'm just trying to survive. There's a party going on right here. Piggy bank. Every time you get one penny, you get two pennies. If you're gonna pick it up, seems like it makes sense to pick it up early. Spent 12 cents on it, so we got 3 back. Eh, it's okay. Alright, let's take a trip down here. Alright, so it is gonna give us... Oh, this is a weird one. I've never seen one that actually allows us to go to a second screen. Ooh, baby. This is really neat. It's a bit of a shame that I don't think I can do jack shit here. Truth be told, none of those items are that amazing. I'd like BOGO bombs. I can't really justify playing that Demon Judgment. I think that'll take us down to the next floor, so I'm... Did I freeze the game? Hello? I guess they didn't expect anybody to... Oh! What the heck? Let me in! Can I... Oh, man. Oh, I made it back. Okay. I don't know how I did it, but we did it. Let's lose one spirit heart to come in here. Not loving that. But Dark Bomb is too good. Secret room is probably here. No? Well, it doesn't look like we'll be able to access our item room, which is really unfortunate, but I'm... And even though it looks like I'm really bad on health right now, Dark Bomb should give me the ability to pretty much leave every floor with the HP cap, except for this floor. But it pays out at a nearly one-to-one rate with red hearts and spirit hearts. So it picks up the red hearts that I don't want and gives me the spirit hearts that I do want, for right now at least. Let's hope that we can get that kind of started, get that chain going before my HP runs out, because we are, you know, we're working on borrowed time here. My HP is pretty low. Come on, come on. Alright, the key. Could have used that last floor, but I can use it this floor as well. That was really dumb of me. I can't afford to take very much more damage like that. Speed up is fine. I don't really want to deal with a mob trap room right now. Of course, at some point we're going to have to. Hey, our charm enemy just killed another enemy. That doesn't happen all that often. HP, oh my god. Just drop red hearts. It's like the most common consumable drop in the game. No. Alright. I know, by the way, that we should definitely be using Book of Belial a little bit more often than we actually are. I do suffer from too good to use syndrome. It's a very serious affliction that affects dozens of us every year. Homing bombs are okay. Red hearts. Pay out some red hearts. Maybe some red hearts? Not any... Red hearts, okay. Shop is next. This is not the shop. Under the water, powering the water. There is water at the bottom of the ocean. Seriously, though. If you could just give me some red hearts, that would be dope. This is not, actually, you know what? I actually think that this Dingle is maybe even a little bit harder than Boss Dingle. Even though he's only got, the one attack, I seem to get hit by it a lot more often, because the room landscape is often a little bit different. Those, like, corner poops on the Dingle boss fight are very effective. I thought Piggy Bank gave us 2 pennies every time we would have gotten 1 penny, but I must be mistaken, I guess. It's a good run right now. We just need some more red hearts to drop. Which, we should get some guaranteed from the boss. Totally we'll buy 9 volt. I know there's a red heart here, but I don't think if I buy it, well, first off, I don't think I can buy it. Secondly, even if I could, I think it would just go to me instead of two dark bombs. So this enemy is a touch tricky. That should have been really bad damage, but I got lucky and didn't get hit there. Okay, so seriously, just keep summoning those hoppers, dog. Much easier for me to deal with than the actual fire. You're almost dead. You're almost dead. He's charmed. I got hit. That's okay. He's dead. Dropped half a red heart. You owe me, Dark Bomb. You owe me one. Go pick it up. Spirit Heart. Thank you. Jesus Juice. Damage plus range up. Krampus? Well, we can't pick that up. But maybe. No, we're probably not going to get a deal with the Angel, all things considered, are we? Now that I think about it critically. Okay, let's do some more exploration, because really, like, there's a huge incentive to explore every single room, because every red heart gives us a chance to get spirit hearts. One of these is a speed up, I'll take it. One of these is balls of steel, amazingly useful. And one of them is I found pills, not so bad. If we find some blue fire, we will definitely be blowing it up. This is a little bit more of my style of run from vanilla. It's a bit cheeky, low on HP, high on damage already, although I'd like it to be higher, and you know, Book of Belial, one of my favorite vanilla spacebar items. Definitely like top, 20%. And then 9-volt makes it even better. I'm gonna go to our curse room, just because there's huge possibilities for greatness here. High base damage will always, always, always be preferable for me. Apologies for the low brightness on this room, by the way. But will always, always be preferable to me compared to high HP. If you can only have one or the other, give me the high base damage. Which, luckily, is where we're at right now. I like our chances here. I would like them a little bit more if we got some more red heart drops randomly. That's okay, though. You can't always get what you want. I can't help but feel like we're just a little bit away from making this run really, really great. And I mean that sincerely. Like, I don't think we're too many items away from being in a very, very successful position. A potential Shoal or Mom's Heart victory. Let's see if we can get through some floors without taking damage. Come on, Bomb. Or Dark Bomb. Don't tell me that, like, overnight they released a patch that nerfed his drop rate or something like that. But, I think we could maybe get a Shoal victory here if we get lucky. Let's try to get that Samson unlock as well by not taking damage on the next two floors. I wouldn't consider it too bloody likely, but it could happen. Either way, we're knocking out Mom's Heart kills that should allow us to get the like permanent Shoal unlock. Charm some of them. Charm some of them. Thank you. All right, charm silkworms. They murdered each other. That's not really what I was looking for, but I appreciate it nonetheless. Thank you. That was really good. Boss trap room. Sure. Oh, Dark Bomb, work with me, buddy. Yes. Okay. Could use some bombs to sort out Chubb a little faster. At the very least, we got a spirit upper coming down here. Yeah, Chubb, murder your own, you're young there. Okay, now you turned on me. I don't know if I appreciate that as much as I thought we had something special going on a little earlier. Wouldn't it be great if we managed to turn a silkworm against Chubb to the point where the silkworm actually got the kill? Probably not gonna happen. That's okay, though. Alright, what do we do here? Charming Peep doesn't really do too much for us, I think. But we'll just keep stacking up damage. It's the simple way. Which sometimes is the only way. Yeah, we could maybe charm the eye. That was terrible dodging on my part. Oh, every time we get hit, we get money. Is that piggy bank? I'm gonna forget those for a while. That was terrible. Just rest assured. So we've broken even on this room and ruined my morale for unlocking Samson, so that's fantastic. But hey, at least we didn't lose the HP on it. We actually picked up a bomb. Wonderful. Don't love taking two hits on Peep. Shit happens sometimes, though. Get charmed. Yeah. Get charmed is like the new get fucked. Get wrecked, nerd. I made you like me, you dork. Then I murdered you. Some Sharon Stone shit right there. Glenn Close. Yeah, alright. I can get down with the charms here. They're working out fairly well. Chemical Peel. Chemical Peel is another weird kind of damage upgrade that only affects half of our tiers. Or might affect both of them, but it only changes the color on half of them. Little unusual to get two of those in the same run, but hey. That's Reboyth for you. Now, if you could drop some red hearts. Like, this is the only run that I can recall where I've been like, give me red hearts, please. Normally, you get way too many to even know what to do with them. Not this time, though. Not this time, though. Key would be useful. Oh, there's something over here. It is a key. Yeah, I'll go to our shop. I kind of hope we fight greed. Be careful what you wish for, I guess. And greed seems to very often drop the Steam sale for us in Rebirth. But again, it's so early that that shit's still like pretty much just anecdotal. But there you go. It's proven. I am pretty sure I've had like 5 different runs where I've had 2 Steam sale drops in the same run as well. Oh, I didn't expect you to start off so quickly here. So we have a double boss room. That's not so bad. What's my course of action here? Yeah, get some charms going, if possible. Ooh, tricky dodge. Yeah, once you get a charm going, hopefully they can kind of slow the other ones down. I do need to kill them when they get into the slime state, though, but the mushrooms are making that kind of tricky. You know what would be really charming after I charmed you is if you just straight up died. That would be nice. I did take some dumb damage there, but I mean, it's not really dumb damage. This room's kind of tricky. Guys are getting bounced around like crazy. These mushrooms are blocking all these shots that I need them to hit. Money. Money's not HP, though. I'm not sure if you guys have noticed that. Double pin. Pop Book of Belial quickly. That was a panic pop. I actually hit it twice. Doesn't make me feel that good. So I don't know if charmed pin can hurt the other pin. I certainly hope that's the case. It doesn't look like the bomb does it. Whoa! Okay, never mind. That was like a sweet kind of kamikaze attack there. I appreciate it. Ooh. Speed upgrade. That's not red hearts, by the way. Dark bum, you owe me. So really, we're just going to stay at the same HP every floor. That's exciting. Give me some spirit hearts here. Or a free item. Okay, very funny. Well, we'll keep exploring. And I'll keep waiting for these red hearts to spawn. Oh, come on. Yeah? Yeah, okay, this is where it gets overpowered. Use one more bomb to get the spirit heart here. I still don't want any of those items in the devil room, I think, but this is starting to come up Millhouse here. Now, we can lose this HP pretty easily. But this is a good start. Finally, starting to get our sea legs here on this run. Get some momentum, maybe even be able to take a deal with the devil on the next floor if we get super lucky. Tarot card is the tower, not very good. You know what? Let's not let this bullshit happen to us again. Use Book of Belial. Hopefully get some charms going here. Well, we charmed one and then he immediately went into the ooze state, so he's not going to be doing too well for us here. It's okay. I really think that Dark Bomb in normal circumstances... Oh, this is crazy lucky now. In normal circumstances, Dark Bomb could be one of those items that actually ends up just winning the game for you. Ugh, in and of itself. Or by itself. Let's take a look at our map. Did we teleport at some point? Like, is that what we've got going on here? We will go to our curse room. We must have teleported out of one room. So I'll take the map off there. Apologies. I wish that the map did fit all on the screen at the same time, but, you know, there's a lot more stuff going on here. I can understand why they had to kind of work around the HUD a little bit. It's unfortunate. I also wish there was a default option that just showed what floor you were on. Pays to remember. We're on caves too. Another key. Very glad I came to this room then. A lot of these rooms, unfortunately, but usually you get a consumable drop at the end anyway. Sweet. Yeah. I don't know if it was worth a full spirit heart, but we did it. See if there's a secret room here. Excellent. I did not expect that on the first crack. Lucky us. And hopefully that'll be another spirit heart. Dark Bum, you're too good to me. If you have, like, Dark Bum and the Mitre, or maybe you have Dark Bum and Little Chad or something like that, like, I'm pretty sure that you just win. Guppy's Hairball, Brother Bobby. I still think, like, now that I have the HP, those items are still not worth taking, so I'm gonna move along. Depths 1. At least it's not Necropolis. We can enjoy that together. I don't know if there's a set ratio for Dark Bum to pay out. All I know is that it has the funniest name for an item in Rebirth. But it seems like sometimes it pays out on a half heart, sometimes it pays out on a full heart. I'm not sure if that's it hitting like some kind of quota or if it works on some kind of different mechanic. I appreciate it nonetheless. We're now rolling in spirit hearts. Again, it should allow us to pretty much hit the HP cap whenever we leave a floor. Use Book of Belial here. Should be using it more often. Again, with our 9 volt, we can pretty much use it every other room. So I really have no reason to save it except not even laziness, just kind of like ignorance. Yeah, we are going to be able to go to our shop. Shops have been good for us so far. I would love to get a Humbling Bundle, which would just be amazing considering that we would have a much better chance to get a lot of red hearts and convert those into spirit hearts. Anyway, it's going to be a super greed fight, which is unexpected and a little unfortunate. That being said, I still, you know, I'm not that salty about the fact that I don't have Book of Belial ready for this room. We'll have Book of Belial ready for our next room. And should probably use it. Oh yeah, there we go. Super Greed's going to town. When you get all the enemies charmed, they just fight each other and they all do damage to one another, which is sweet. 32 cents. We can use those hopefully at our next shop, unless we end up fighting Greed again. I really don't think this room is worth come on, just throw a bone or something here. I really don't think this room is worth using Book of Belial on. And of course, immediately almost take damage to a bony right off the bat. And this room could be worth using it on if the boss room is not right next door. So this is our first floor where we really have a great chance of getting a deal with the devil right off the bat. Let's make it happen. I'm interested. Game's interested. Come on, half heart payout. Oh, you're too good to me. Okay. Monstro 2. Not so bad. Let's pop this right away. And you know what? I wouldn't mind using a tower card here. Do we have homing bombs? Did I forget that we have homing bombs? I mean, it's not really that much of an item that has an enormous effect on your game for the most part, but if I'd had homing bombs, I might have used them on some of these bosses. Pin, for example. Homing bombs can make him a little bit easier. There's not really much point to charming Monstro too, I think, considering he already does damage to the minions he creates, but sure, you know, we'll just add it to our another notch on our bedpost, I guess. Oh, we got a serious frame rate issue here that I am not a big fan of. You know what just caused this? Was me getting a message on Steam. So just hold up for a second. We're probably going to take 9 lives here. I'm going to put on my overlay, and hopefully we can deal with this. Close this. Sign off online on Steam. I swear to God, if this causes issues here... I'm gonna be mad, but the frame rate takes like a huge hit when other stuff takes precedent here. Hmm. Oh, there it goes, it's back. Alright. Sorry for putting my overlay up there for a second. There we go. We're gonna take Spirit of the Night, I think. Yeah, well, I think we'd be stupid not to. We definitely don't want the Guppy item, and we already have a better book than Book of Sin, so why not? So yeah, if you're having frame rate issues in Isaac, there's a couple of things you can do. There's a thread on the Binding of Isaac, the subreddit, reddit.com/r/bindingofisaac, that you should check out. But one thing that I've done is just disable my Steam overlay in-game, and it seems to get really laggy when people send me messages. So I try to stay offline on Steam, and then I just kind of like let it work for 15 seconds, and it usually figures it out. If you're having frame rate issues, I feel bad for you, son. I feel so bad that I'll give you some advice about how to have more fun. There you go. I don't need to resort to foul language. That was just terrible play on my part. Ooh, I like this room. I'll take my free bombs. Yes, please. I will go back to that big room, but, you know, we don't really need to right now. And I feel a little salty about the fact that I already took some dumb damage on it, so we'll save it for later. I like when you charm the... Oh, such awful damage. My speed's so high, I'm not used to it. Come on, bum friend. Placate me. Thank you. I would probably be doing a lot better right now if I wasn't taking so much dumb damage. But yeah, charming the leapers, that seems like one of the most useful charms, because they actually do kind of, like, leap home to the other enemies. Got kind of a long room up here, adjacent to the item room. Again... Oh, yeah, that seems like another great charm right there, but should be using Book of Belial as much as possible. If we get, like, a AAA battery, I think we might be able to use it on every room, which would actually be insane. Talk about damage upgrades. Book of Belial on every room is... That's up there as far as good damage upgrades go. Careful. These guys can still turn on you. Not one-shotting them yet. Don't get cocky, kid. Ooh, this is Tiny Planet? So Tiny Planet is an item that a lot of people consider bad. I don't necessarily disagree. Oh, it's anti-gravity. Okay, so anti-gravity tears, they just kind of float in the air, and whatever direction you press when you're firing them, when you let go, they'll all fire in that direction. So I could fire like tears in four different directions here, and when I let go, it goes like that. This is an item that has some amazing synergies, but is also a little bit tricky to use, which is kind of my style. For fighting stationary enemies, it should be very easy. Hopefully. We can't stand still for very long, but we should be able to take care of these nubs without too much trouble. It's an item that certainly has a little bit of a learning curve associated with it, and I've seen people in kind of equal numbers complain about this item and kind of sing its praises. One thing you can do is just slowly walk backwards and then unleash all the shots at the same time if an enemy is chasing you, and it'll be a nightmare for them. There you go. Pill is hematemesis, which actually, in that case, had some sweet synergy. I thought it was going to be useless for us, but it gave us a free spirit heart. There's some cool synergies here. Hopefully we'll be able to see them, but, you know, unless we get something like, what am I trying to say here? Unless we get something like, the magician? Spoonbender, that's it. Unless we get something like Spoonbender, we're probably not going to have much of a chance. But that being said, I think we can still concoct a winning run out of this. What's interesting is that you can see my shots have kind of like a diagonal on them as well. That's because it stores the momentum that it makes when you're moving. So like if I'm moving up or down, you can see that momentum is stored as they get shot. It's a really cool idea. And it's one of the most kind of like novel new items in the game, which I think is sweet. So yeah, I'm very happy to have it here. Let's move along. And we still don't want anything in here, right? Yeah, those are still pretty bad. All right. Down to the next floor. I'm thinking that this is pretty much a no-brainer for our first mom's heart kill. This is our mom fight. Maybe some items in here? Ugh. Demon judgment or something? Ugh. Well, we'll probably donate a lot. Let's see what we got here. Might as well use Book of Belial. I'm happy we've gone through with this because there is a spirit heart here. The thing is, teleporting enemies can occasionally make you look like a big idiot when you're using anti-gravity. Because, you know, they'll teleport behind you and then all your shots will go in the wrong direction. You know, you gotta have a little bit of foresight there, I guess. Alright, this is like old school ass Monstro 2 model here, that's cool. Oh. I think that anti-grav tears can be really useful against enemies that charge at you as well. Or enemies that jump, because if they jump to the location where you used to be, you know, they're gonna get hit by at least some tears there, because the tears are created like pretty much right where you're standing. I think it would be really useful if you had freezing tears as well, or like even slowing tears, but charm tears don't seem crazy useful. I also think that we would benefit a lot right now just from, you know, not any crazy synergies, but just give me like increased tears so we could fire more frequently. Oh, nice. Because as of right now, I am having a little bit of trouble spawning as many shots as I'd like. Also, piercing or penetrative tears would be incredible. Oh, cool, yeah. Sweet. I think we got lucky to land a shot there. Balls of steel. We're in a kind of an enviable position that we don't even want to use balls of steel right now because we're at the HP cap. Give me some more cool bomb synergies. Homing bombs plus another kind of bomb would be sweet. I can't believe that I'm having better luck actually getting these bombs to hit Wrath when I am not even able to time my shots appropriately. Oh well. Yeah, sure, he walked himself into the bomb. That's nice. Well, three bombs for free. Okay. And the anti-gravity tears, I've only had them once, so I'm not like an expert or anything, even though I might seem like I'm pretending like I'm an expert. It seems like they're really a lot better against stationary enemies as well. So these enemies can be a little annoying, but, you know, as they move, they also just run into them occasionally. But, yeah, it seems like we do a lot better against stationary enemies. Enemies that are made, you know, with some paper. Alright, now just kind of walk backwards and we'll do some Geometry Wars style shit here. One's dead. Oh, we did get the other one. That's a surprise. Okay. Curse room. Thank God we're not fighting spiders for once. Eh, we got a spirit heart out of it. Only cost us half a spirit heart to go in. I know we should be using Book of Belial. You should mind your own effing business. That's my philosophy on it. No. I'm just joking. I appreciate the advice. I'm glad that we're kind of starting to string together some winning runs here, though, because I was nervous for a while that I was just going to be absolute dog shit at Rebirth, even worse than Vanilla, and a lot of early runs kind of looked that way. I think that's largely, that's the Bob's brain effect. Alright, so I'm just going to, I bet we can beat Chubb without even firing our shots. Just kind of setting them behind us, letting Chubb chase us down and walk into them. Yeah, that seems to be doing an awful lot of damage. There's stupid damage on my part, but that's okay. Yeah, this is an easy way to do this. Anti-grav tears, they give you pretty good accuracy if an enemy's just chasing you down. Item room, this is inner eye. Oh, baby! Cool synergy. I think it might actually be worse. But that's okay, because it looks cooler, and that's the most important thing. If we could just get homing shots. Wow, good aim there. There we go. Oh, come on. Still nothing. Alright, we could use Balls of Steel if we wanted to. We could get 5 free bombs if we wanted to. That's a little bit more tempting, I think. I can't believe I'm not breaking the fire, like, instantly. And our shop contains a pretty good item for us here. And you know what? I'm going to buy this rather than use Balls of Steel. And I'm going to buy this. And I'm going to donate like crazy. Just jam ourselves in behind the machine here. Come on. And really, I don't care how much money we spend on this. I don't want to work. And just want to give taxable donations all day until my accountant says that it's no longer a good idea. Seriously, though. Come on. 150? Oh, we can't even get to 150. We can get to 149 if it doesn't break. Let's shoot some of the fire here. Maybe we can actually get a little further. No? You know there's going to be something at 150. It's the Pokemon number. Now we can see where the boss room is, by the way. That makes me not want to be on this room so much. Let's take care of the nubs first. Now that the nubs are gone, we'll just do like our triple shot walk backwards technique here. It's a pretty good one. Sweet, that's over. And come on. Come on. And when I get a full red heart, it's like a 90% chance, I think, that it gives us the actual payout we want. For example. Oh, we have explored this entire floor. I thought the boss room was going to be in a completely different direction. Alright, I'm feeling pretty chuffed, as they might say, with this run right now. I feel like we're in a good position. It would be nice to have some, like a headless baby or something like that. Not in real life, of course. That would be horrifying. I don't even think that needs to be said. Well, I used the wrong item. I used Balls of Steel when I meant to use, Book of Belial. That is a, not even a textbook mistake. Just me being a bit of an idiot. I, sort of don't know how to use anti-grav tears effectively against Mom. Kind of just throwing them down around me at all times in the hope that the foot steps on them, and it's worked out alright so far. We can also plan our shots a little bit. You know, we put them in one direction. We don't have to fire them right away. We can wait till the bodily segment actually pops up. I think, honestly, a lot of my hits have been by accident, though. We're not done with this yet? I'm a little surprised. Hey, there we go. That'll do it. Alright, so we get HP, tears up, shot speed down. Shot speed down I don't love, but tears up I do. We're totally going to take the mark. And that allows us to also get the spirit heart back here. So that's a little bit of increased damage for us as well. Alright, next floor. Oh, we don't need the spirit heart because we got it from the mark. Fair enough. This is presumably a win here. I love the change. So we can actually, there's our boss room right off the bat. Oh, that was terrible. So we can actually, get a deal with the devil without having to use the, like the fool card or any other kind of teleport. Usually ended up being the fool. Alright, just line up some shots here, let them all go at once. You can see why, like, Mom's contact would be really useful here. But I think, really, the item that I'd be going for is either a ton of tears. No question, that would be cool. Or, piercing shots, like straight up vanilla Cupid's arrow. Spirit heart? No spirit heart. Oh, this is a mini boss, not a regular boss. All right, I feel fairly stupid right now, justifiably probably. But piercing shots would be so good on these rooms that actually have a lot of enemies. Congrats, guys, we got Anarchist Cookbook. I'm really excited about that. Oh, our boss room is way the heck down there. This still looks like it could be the right way, though. Kind of surprised that worked, to be honest with you. I mean, you might as well get you to pay out just in case we need the spirit hearts later. That's an easy way to handle that. Let's try it again, round two here. I can live with it. Battery. Alright, gave us an empty red heart, which is a little weird considering our circumstances, but it's okay. Like, we can get good use out of the battery, but at the same time, like, I also don't really want to use my Book of Belial on a room that bad. We have a spirit heart back here that we'll go back and pick up. And, the mom's heart kill, at this point I'd say probably, foregone conclusion. Satan kill? Well, I guess we could just get the feet to, like, walk backwards into our shots, which would probably kill them pretty quickly. Now, we learned this last time, that if one of them pays out, the other one's gonna explode, but we don't have any HP to give to Demon Judgment anyway. Oh, the other one didn't explode! And we got Black Bean, which I think we've gotten for the first time now on this save. Come on, I could use that Spirit Heart. Oh, fine. Wow, I'm very displeased with the fact that I took damage right off the bat on Blast Assist, but I think Blast Assist is gonna be a pretty easy boss fight. I'm just kind of like lining up a bunch of shots and then letting them all go at once. It's not quite the Wall of Death that I was expecting, but I also didn't even use Book of Belial because I'm an idiot, and now it feels like we shouldn't even use Book of Belial because, you know, the boss is like 80% dead, if not more. Range upgrade is not really what I'm most excited about here. I am excited about Krampus, though, because I do have Book of Belial still stored up here. Now, I can play your charge game too, Krampus. Don't even sweat that shit. Okay, well, maybe I'm bad at it, but I can play it nonetheless. Give us Krampus's head. You know what? I'm fine with Lump of Coal. We've got some good range. Thank you. But I do wish that you'd given me Krampus's head. I don't even know how that works with anti-grav. Where is our boss? Well, we got something interesting going on up here. Crash into me, please, like a Dave Matthews Band song. Wow, look at how our shots grow with Lump of Coal. This is the first time I've seen this, like, demonstrably in action. Ready? Here we go. Yeah, they get a lot bigger as they move along. That is something I could probably use for my favor here. That seems okay. Three keys for one spirit heart. We got a lot of keys, so I can't really sweat that interaction. Boss room, bottom right. Let's try going this way first. Okay, that's that settles it. Come on, give me another spirit heart. Well, we'll blow it up. I'm not too worried about our HP, all things considered. Fair enough, alright, you've redeemed yourself. It's only these weird little nubs. I still don't know what those things do, which is why I try to kill them as soon as possible, because as much as I want to know, I don't know if I really want to know, you know? I think this makes it really easy to deal with doppelgangers once you actually figure out what you're doing. Not super stoked about that damage. There is some HP awaiting us, by the way. I will go back and get it if the time is right. Okay, here's what I'm thinking. Create some shots, and just do that. This is indeed the right way to get to the boss room. Don't love those brimstone wall hugger guys. Yeah, don't love them at all. Thanks for the golden key, just in time. Well, I didn't want to do this, but we're gonna go back and look for our, I don't know why I tried that out. We're gonna go back and look for our, spirit heart here. And by look for, I mean seriously, just like literally look on the map and go pick it up. It's like, I'm gonna go look for my keys. Where are they? Well, in my pocket, but, you know, I gotta look for them. Sometimes I can't speak English, and it's a little bit bothersome because that's the only language I speak, and if I can't communicate in that, it puts me in a bit of a weird spot. Anyway, Mom's Heart. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. We are doing this. Well, kind of missed on the actual enemies I'm supposed to be hitting, but hit the heart. Jeez, this is not going so well right now. Alright. Big moments here. We can do a ton of damage when we just store up our shots. I'll just focus on dodging as much as we can around the center here. Alright, the second half of this fight has gone a lot better than the first half. Good stuff. It's not easy to shoot these shots while still dodging. Like, circle strafing with this kind of weird anti-grav shit we got going on is a little tricky. It's almost done, though. It wasn't so bad. I can live with it. And we do get to go down to Shoal. We unlocked a couple of things here. I don't want to spoil it for you, though. Come on. Come on. Thank you. Whoa, black card that time. That's unusual. You'll see it, I guess, after we go through this little vignette. Fetus in a jar. And challenge number 9, Demo Man. I guess that's what you get for beating the game as Judas. Curse of the Unknown. Doesn't let us see how much health we have left. That is cruel. Boss fight is bottom left. Yeah, that is a cruel play on this final floor. So I don't even know how close to death I am. Oh, I so wish that one bullet just killed you. Not pleased with that. You can make it up to me. Give me a spirit heart here. No such luck, huh? These guys should be easy. Red hearts. More red hearts. We can use them. I got extremely lucky to not take damage there. Oh, if only we had a familiar to keep doing damage to charmed enemies. I want something else to get me through this. Semi-charmed kind of haunt. Baby, baby. Another black heart. Weird. This is a dead end. Should probably be using a little bit of Book of Belial here, but so far the last few rooms have been relatively easy in that regard. And we're like one hit with full blast at least is enough to kill the zombies, so those guys actually become really easy because they just are guaranteed to walk into our bullets. This guy might be a little bit more of a liability for us. Oh, that was bad of me. Especially considering he was charmed. I have no idea how much HP we have. It scares the shit out of me. I don't even know what's happening here. I guess I kind of like it. We are going to have to go through the big room. Oh, the invisible guy got me. Not great. No spirit hearts. I have no idea how much HP we have, so I have no idea if I'm close to death or if I'm ages away. You know what? I would like to extinguish this fire. I think if we extinguish this fire, this room could be easy. I'm gonna use Book of Belial as well. Alright, now we're finally getting started here. Got some real damage thanks to, like, Lump of Coal. One last greed. Come on, red hearts. That's it? Oh, there's still an enemy. Oh, there he is. Ah, no red hearts, just money. No Dana, only Zool. That is not a red heart, I'm not sure if you noticed this. So we'll save our Book of Belial for the next room. I think we got a decent chance, but honestly, I have no idea how much FN HP we have, so I could be full of shit, basically. Even more so than usual. It's okay. I do wish we had Book of Belial available for this room. I guess we do, but I probably shouldn't use it. Come on, come on. Even giving me one extra hit of survivability is so useful here. Alright, let's do this Satan fight. I believe I'm ready. Do it. Solid enough. No, where are you going? You're not supposed to be down there, though. Come back. Alright, we got him to split. That's pretty good. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Alright, that's one way to do that. Seriously, though, where are you going? All right, now, I think that the Satan fight should be easy. Like, this phase of the Satan fight should be easy, even though I keep getting hit. Because he stays in pretty much the same place. So it shouldn't be too much of a... Oh, no. Well, at least we know we just lost a black heart, so we're not on, like, red hearts yet. Which we only have one of anyway. Never mind. I lost. I don't feel great about that. And we didn't complete any more of our Polaroid, but... We did get a Judas Mom's heart kill. I can't help but feel that Curse of the Unknown had a bit of a, psychological effect on me there, but that's okay. Decent run, a fun run, anti-grav tiers are neat. I guess we'll, yeah, we'll do an Eden run next. We got 8 tokens stored up. We need a Satan kill with Isaac, really? Well, we'll try to knock that out as well. But in any case, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.